Between the double roll-up garage doors was a white wooden door that Dolores and family members used as the main entrance to the house. Anybody inserting a key into that door had 20 seconds to walk across the garage and flick a switch to keep the alarm from sounding. Dolores pulled the Volkswagen between her recently repaired green Oldsmobile Cutlass and Janie's 1970 gold Chevrolet Nova. She got out carrying her beige purse, a yellow-bound Bible, the Sunday paper, the gas receipt, the white sweater she'd carried against the morning coolness, and her keys on two rings held together by a safety pin. She was about to insert one of those keys into the center garage door when a shot rang out, splattering the door with her blood. The shot was followed quickly by another, and a few seconds later by a third. 2. When Dolores Lynch moved into the big house on Covered Bridge Road late in 1970, she vowed that this was the last move she would make. She was 54, her children were grown, and every time she had begun to establish roots, she had been yanked up and moved. She resented it. Needing order and stability, she felt haunted by change. Not since her early childhood in Pittsburgh's East End had she had security of place. Her father, John Rogers, a machinist at Union Switch and Signal Company, had died in 1932 when Dolores was 15, leaving his wife, Lily, and two teenage children to fend for themselves in the depths of the Depression. Dolores's brother, Elmer, 3 years older, took upon himself the responsibility of seeing that the family had a roof over their heads and food on the table, and that his younger sister would be able to stay in Westinghouse High School and eventually achieve her dream of becoming a nurse. But work was scarce, pay short, and as the family's situation steadily deteriorated, they were forced to move several times. The hardships of those years would have a lifelong effect on Dolores, who decades later still proclaimed that nobody ever lived poorer than she.